Hey friends, Next.js is one of the most popular JavaScript frameworks for building complex server-driven React applications. Azure Static Web Apps now includes enhanced Next.js support that includes server-side rendering and incremental static regeneration. Reshmi is here to show me how all these hybrid scenarios work today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Reshmi. How are you?
I'm good. I'm amazing. And thanks so much for having me here.
It's absolutely my pleasure. So big things happening in the Next.js space with regards to Azure Static Web Apps. You're just making it better and better every release.
Yeah, I'm glad this topic is just trending and we are at the right market right now because we have recently, that is since October, we have started supporting hybrid rendering support in Next.js. If you look at the Jamstack conference, the numbers clearly show that one out of every three developers is inclined towards trying Next.js. And here today, we are going to talk about how Static Web Apps enhances your developer experience by bringing so many features, power pack features such as zero config support. You can have server-side rendering, incremental static regeneration, API routes, static side generation, like all of these power-packed in just one application. And the best part, because it's tied up with Static Web Apps, we also have all the free SOAR benefits which we provide day-to-day, right? Like you can have free SSL certificates, you can have your custom domains, you can upgrade to have enterprise-grade support across the globe, and many more. So I am pretty excited, and I'm sure anyone who is reading this is also excited.
Yeah, it's really interesting to me as someone who's used to doing things in Azure Web Apps, which are more dynamic and really kind of more expensive. You're really pushing the limits of what SWAs can do, what Static Web Apps can do, but they're still very affordable, even though they're including these features.
That's totally correct. So if we can just quickly dive into the architecture, I will show you how In this scenario, we can have different kinds of rendering happening in one single application. So CSR is something very common across all the React frameworks and all the frameworks which are currently being popular, right? So CSR is basically the processing is happening on the client end. All the HTML and JavaScript comes to your terminal and then they get rendered and processed to your page. But in case of static site generator, with sites like Gatsby and Hugo, they are popular frameworks again. The architecture basically looks at the code goes to Static Web Apps when you send a request. The first thing it does is it checks if it's already having a cache. If there is a cache, it's just going to get the response. But if there is no cache, the Next.js, which is running in our API, managed API Azure function, it just goes to the call and gets back all the data. And the snippet that you can see below, that basically shows the function which does the static props call. So this transaction is just going to be as seamless as it gets, but because it's static site generator, the whole rendering is happening during build time. So it's completely pre-rendered. And to add to the benefits of it, incremental static regeneration is basically helping you stale the cache for some time. So once you are done with the transaction, if the cache is not present in your cache storage, it comes back and stores the cache again in the cache storage. And then you set a revalidation time. Like for suppose in the snippet, we have this line which is saying 10 seconds, yeah? So for 10 seconds, if anytime you're trying to access the same thing again, it's just going to get it from the cache. It's going to be as fast as it gets. And again, it has the pre-rendering benefit. And finally, the server-side rendering benefit, which is the highlight of Static Web Apps and Next.js combination, is now we also support not only client, but server, where every request goes all the way to the manage function. You get the data as is, and it's as dynamic as it gets. It's completely stateful. You do not have to worry about any sort of stale content or anything which is probably not up to date. And for this, Next.js provides this function, which is called get server-side props, and you get a return of a JSON property having the whole page rendered and you just give it. So all of these is basically going to help in improving a lot of performances, especially with SEO optimization, because everything is already processed and you don't have these JavaScript tags or you don't have variables which have to come and get processed only once it comes to the browser. So that, in short, is how we are going to look at further. But I'm sure if you have anything to discuss and your thoughts, I'm ready to take that.
I would like to understand just that last part, the server-side rendering. Where is that occurring? Is that occurring within the context of the static web app, or is it happening in a managed function that maybe I don't see or I don't have to think about? Who turned the JavaScript curly braces into angle brackets and did the server-side rendering?
Okay, that's a wonderful question. So to answer it, basically, the manage function is where our Next.js is currently running. So all the code processing, which has anything to do with server-side rendering, everything happens over there. And then we get the optimized result, and that comes back to the static web app. But while we are at this, I would love to take this opportunity to also say that we are currently working on another enhancement, which helps in splitting the static and dynamic content for rendering. So now going forward, the static content is going to be rendered all on static web apps. Again, it's still happening before it reaches the client, but we are going to split it such that only the dynamic part is going to do the whole transaction all the way through the API, but the static content is going to be even quicker available. It's going to be ready over there. So
interesting. Yeah. Now I point out that, of course, I said who, because I'm anthropomorphizing the architecture, but I was trying to understand there's the web server, the static web apps that does some work. And then there's the partner, which is Azure Functions. So you're going to move that from Functions over to static web apps, which is going to make it so much faster.
That's correct. That's perfectly correct.
Great. All right. Awesome. Cool. I'd love to see a demo of this in action.
Yes, I am super stoked as well. So here I have this sample repository. So for the time saving, I've just already created a repository. This basically is just a simple Next.js hybrid static web apps, which contains CMS from WordPress and Cosmos DB for fetching our comments, right? So I've already created a sample repository. What I'm going to do is I'm going to clone this to my local. So I go get clone. Awesome. And once it clones, I'm just going to switch to that repo. AZ Friday. Sorry, what was the name? Oh, sorry. It's NWP AZ Friday. And let's go to the repo. Okay, awesome. Cool. So now we can definitely explore the pages, but I am going to do the first things first. I'm going to already deploy the static web apps, right? So VS Code has an Azure Static Web Apps extension, and it's basically an Azure. You get all the resources over here, and you can quickly do. But I'm going to do Ctrl-Shift-P because I am trying to be pro command shortcut person. I'm going to create a quick static web apps over here. I have logged into my Azure account, so it's going to ping my Azure, do the login, and make sure that I have it handy with me. Use my private subscription. I'm going to create this demo, let it call AZ Friday. I'm good there. So here it asks me, where is the nearest region do you want to deploy? And in case of Next.js, it's crucial because we are deploying it completely in our managed functions, right? So for me, maybe East Asia is the best. So I'm going to go for East Asia. And then among the build preset, you already see an option for Next.js SSR. So all you have to do is opt for that. It's going to autofill the contents. You just click next and next. So now my static web apps is being created. And I can just sit back and wait for the information block to come up saying, hey, your static web apps is up and ready. So while we wait for this, I'm going to quickly show how it looks like in the browser, right? Oh, sorry. I can actually show the code base. My bad. Okay. So if we see the code base here, right? So the structure basically static web apps follows is it has a folder called pages, and that's where the whole of the source content stays. API is where the API routes call go, which is the Next.js application can do further API calls, which does the transaction inside the API folder. And this is taking care of all the other changes. So here, if I were to say, I want to see static props, right? So the function static props is going to get all my posts and process it and give my home page over there with static site generation. But hey, wait, we do have one more line, which is saying revalidate. And the revalidate line is technically making it from an SSG to an ISR. That is, now for every 10 seconds, my code is going to stay as is. And if I try to refresh the page, it's going to stay. So I can see that it succeeded. So I really want to like go quickly check the logs and see what the status is. But meanwhile, I am open to questions if you have any.
So there's get static props within the context of Next.js, but then there's also get server-side props. What are the differences?
That's correct. That's a wonderful question, and I'm glad you asked it because that's the next thing I was going to go to. So if you see the posts, right, there's this page called slug.dsx. So what exactly slug.dsx is, the parenthesis basically says the name of the page is variable. It picks the name of the blog that I want, and then it does, oh, now that I think about it, I think this might fail because I didn't do npm install, but never mind. We can check this later. Cool. So if you see the slug page, right? So it basically has contents for all the blogs and it has the sequence of how the blog page looks like. But the server-side props is how you're defining the property of the blog, that everything is coming together as a server process that is processed before it reaches the client. And you get a packed property with preview, post, comments, and all. And if you see the comments, this is basically going to call the respective blog and connect to the Cosmos DB, pick all the comments which are related to that blog and get it back over here. So server-side rendering over here is basically looking at WordPress, looking at Cosmos DB, getting all the content together and giving it back to Static Web Apps as a unit. So that's what we are expected to see right now. I'm not sure if this build will succeed, actually, because npm install is something missing. But in case it doesn't, I already have a backup package because, you know, demo gods.
I appreciate your preparation, indeed.
Yeah. While we are staying at this, I'm going to quickly show one more thing, right? So if you look at the existing application, so what exactly happens is once your Static Web Apps is deployed, which we can see over here as well, looking at AZ Friday, right? Once your Static Web Apps is deployed, if you go to the portal page, to the overview, you should be able to see a dedicated URL which shows what page your site will be at. You should be able to see the GitHub action runs from here. So you can basically just navigate back to your GitHub and track on what the status is for the build. And at the same time, you should be able to add more configurations. In our case, because we are using Cosmos DB as well, it's really important that in configurations, we add this application setting called Cosmos Key. And I have my personal Cosmos Key. This is going to make sure that when I visit the website and I write a comment, the comment actually reflects when I revalidate. Otherwise, it's basically just throwing the comment to the site and coming back in a CSR fashion, but it's not retained, right? So yeah, I'm just going to leave it as is. I'm going to go to the existing demo while it's still working. So here you see, this is a very simple website. It's a travel blog. I love traveling. So I thought, you know, why not? Let's just write about something which you're passionate about. You can just quickly bring this page up. So this is a travel blog where I'm talking about most of my recent travels, right? I went to Jodhpur, I went to Goa, blah, blah, blah. So all of these pages, if you see, I don't know if you noticed, but when I was scrolling, the images were loading now and then, right? It was not loading at a bunch because ISR basically supports lazy loading. So lazy loading is the whole page load does not go together in the browser. As and when you scroll, your content keeps coming. So it's more optimized.
When the image then enters the viewport, then it's loaded.
Exactly. Yeah. And Next.js also helps in image optimization. So all of these images, even though they're like high resolution, they're already been compressed and stored in such a format that it's probably taking just minute of KBs, right? It's not going to be heavy at all. And now if I'm supposedly checking out this article, so as you can see this URL, right? /post/ the Great Indian Travelogue. This is something which was filled in by that slug.tsx.
That's the slug, right? Okay.
Yes. Yes. So if you go to this browser, you can see all the content over here, but you can also see comments. So suppose I'm going to write a comment from Scott. And you could say, welcome to Azure Friday. Okay. So now if I hit send, my comment has basically gone over here. And I want to confirm if that comment still stays once I refresh it, right? So when I refresh it, I see that the comment still stays. And how is that happening? For that, if we look at our Cosmos DB, this is the bunch of comments that we have right now. And I look at the latest entry that I have. There you go. So it checks the text, it checks this username, it has everything mapped over here, and it also maps which blog ID it goes to. This is the crucial part, which in our code it checks. Like for every corresponding blog, you get all the comments and you populate it. So basically, Oh, wow, it did succeed. I'm really curious if it worked without NPM install. So if you don't mind, I'm going to quickly
No, of
explore
course.
this. Awesome. Oh my God,
It
it
did
did.
work. Yeah, see,
Wow.
there you go.
I am pretty impressed. Now we can probably see if your comment is over here.
Oh, because it'll be pulling from the same place.
But it's not there
But it's not
because
there
we
because
have
it's going
not
to
put the
be,
Cosmos
because
key.
you haven't set the Cosmos DB ID.
That's correct.
That makes total sense.
Yes. Yes. So if I add the Cosmos key here, I'm going to quickly do that as well because it's not going to take so much time. I have the Cosmos key saved with me already. So I'm just going to copy, Control C, Control V. Okay.
And you're putting that again
Next
on the
slide.
server side. It's never going to be sent out to the client because the client is going to go and send it to a function, and the function's going to put it in Cosmos. So no one's really going to see the key except, of course, everyone who's watching the show.
I hope it was too long for them to capture in their
Yeah.
minds, but
Somebody's going to
yeah.
screenshot it and put it somewhere.
Yeah. But otherwise,
Okay.
that's only a scenario where people can access the key. And because it's a new core static web apps application properties, basically anyone who is operating the application is the only person who has access to it and not otherwise. I'm not sure why it's taking so much time, but I definitely want to take a couple of seconds to talk about the next upcoming things that we have in stock for folks in static web apps. So Next.js is looking at optimizing the performance in, sorry, static web apps is looking at optimizing the performance for Next.js with every passing step. And as of now, we have only done the public preview. So we are really looking forward to have the most powerful support when we announce our GA. So as of now, we already have upcoming works like support for standalone. So what standalone does is, again, it's a specific Next.js property where it compresses your whole project into a minuscule application, and that only has the dependencies which are necessary for your project. So you might have like 10,000 different package.json dependencies, but it goes through the whole project. It picks exactly the one which is necessary, makes a minimal application in a folder. It's like a minimal replica of your whole application, and it brings down your size drastically. Like if it's a 100 MB application, it's probably going to cut it down to maybe like 20 to 30, 40 MB at the most. So you are basically saving so much space, and you can have more bulkier websites. So that's something that we will be announcing very soon. And of course, we are looking for more static web apps related integrations, like integrations with config, integrations with having more auth facilities, having more wildcard processing, things like that. And there's a bunch of updates which is coming. I cannot wait to tell what all it is, but I would just say for all the folks who are watching this, stay tuned because it's up and coming.
Fantastic. So where can I go to learn more about these features that are happening both now and coming soon?
Awesome. So we do have a very power-packed official documentation already available, which goes through all the features that we are supporting right now. And we also have a very lively GitHub discussion chat, which looks at all the updates, right? So if you go to GitHub discussions, this is the top pinned discussion, which you can see like a banner in the top. And there's a beautiful interaction with all the community folks. Everyone's like very keen on interesting and knowing. And you know, people just give us suggestions as well that there's something you should probably consider doing. So these two resources are going to be really handy for your journey. And I would love to hear more from customers anywhere and everywhere. So I'm super stoked that folks are trying out Next.js in static web apps. And I'm sure, Scott, you should probably take out some time for your applications as well. I know you're a big time static web apps fan.
Yes, I have a bunch of sites. I think almost a dozen now in static web apps. So this is
Wow.
great. And this is what's great about Azure Friday is that we know that the community is there. They have opinions, and they know now that you, Reshmi, and the team working on static web apps are listening. You're listening on social
Yes.
media, and you're listening on GitHub. So if you have opinions or thoughts about this feature or others, Reshmi and the team are ready to hear from you. Thanks so much for spending time with me today.
Thank you so much. The pleasure is all mine.
All right, I am learning all about enhanced hybrid Next.js support in Azure Static Web Apps today on Azure Friday. Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.